Video Creations presents the Chicago Blackhawks 1990-91 highlight tape. High hopes, shattered dreams. Brought to you by Coors.
Because at this time of year, you can't hide inside a sweater.
It's the right beer now.
Because you know what to do when good times are on the line.
It's the right beer now.
After working hard to take it off, you don't want to put it back on. Reach for the silver bullet, the one that won't slow you down.
It's right, it's the right beer now. Oh, yeah.
Rain glides under Creighton. Moves in. Center to hit goal. What a...
The Chicago Blackhawks entered the 1990-91 season with a burning desire to be the best. That meant paying the price, and the Hawks went to work in September with training camp, a time to set a course and design a team plan.
The main purpose of training camp at that point is to evaluate your personnel and try to formulate some kind of system and develop the needs of the hockey club.
The Hawks had come prepared, prepared for a month of preparation.
It's 27 days, it's 27 long days. Mike probably went to toughest camp in the National Hockey League, and it's very strenuous, very hard physically and mentally.
To be the best meant being the best condition. And courtesy assistant coach E.J. McGuire, the Hawks' physical status was like the team, tops in the National Hockey League.
And the guys really take a large share of the credit for their ability to have a tough practice and then jump on the bike and really sweat it out or go through a circuit on the weights. So we think that's a large part of the way we play the game. Intensity, hard checking, hard driving.
And so the Hawks kicked off the 1990-91 season with their annual luncheon. Actually, just an appetizer for the real test, defense of the Norris Division title. They entered the season confident and unified.
It's a great group of guys, and you know, we like to have a lot of fun, and we play hard when we're out on the ice, and we're there for each other.
And they were there when the bell rang in October. The Hawks won four of their first five and proceeded on a first-place roll.
Chelios rides it up the board. 10 seconds left in the two-man advantage for Chicago. Veronin, in front, shot, goal!
Ed Belfour won the goalie spot and won the hearts of fans with his outstanding start. It was just as Mike Keenan ordered. A team effort, and a team that came not just to play, but to win.
We're satisfied so far with what's happened, but you know, there's still a long ways to go yet. You know, we've came a long way as far as growing as a team and getting better, and we just have to keep trying to improve every night out.
The leader.
Chelios and Dykos, Creighton, Larmer, and Presley.
He is intense.
Tell him he's looking bad as he is.
He is Mike Keenan.
We just lost the power play for stupidity.
One of the most respected coaches in the National Hockey League, Keenan is bottom line, and he backs it with wins.
I think that I could best be characterized as a person who is committed to a certain level of excellence every day, and expect that from myself and expect that from others.
Let's pick it up now, boys.
Keenan added to his responsibilities in the organization in 1990, moving into the role of general manager as well as coach.
It is more responsibility, but I've enjoyed it a great deal. I think it's another interesting aspect of my career that I can look forward to, and I also enjoy the availability of assessing the overall organizational chart.
Perhaps one of the reasons he maintains his success is that he maintains his desire to learn.
I think that if you stay respectful and have an open mind and are capable of learning things every day, every year, you can develop yourself as a coach. You can be better at your profession.
Wayne and Wayne.
And his approach to his job creates respect from those who work with him.
That was one of the reasons that I wanted to come back, because I wanted to work with Mike. And, you know, he's coached my brothers in different situations in Philly, the Canada Cup, Dwayne here, and we all have a lot of respect for him, and, you know, we can learn from each other.
Yeah, he's a good coach. Everywhere he's been successful, and he's brought a lot more out of a lot of players than the players realize themselves, I think, and, you know, he's a good guy to have.
This goalie plays the puck well, boys. You got to stay away from it.
Keenan is able to bring his team to its highest level, for he has brought hockey in Chicago to a higher level, and the Blackhawks have returned the favor.
It's the special rewards that you get from time to time on the job, the relationship that you might have with a player, or seeing a player develop, or being better, or helping a player in a certain situation that may not give you immediate feedback in the long run, though you see them develop as people and as players, and that's rewarding.
The Hawks had taken over first place from the get-go, and the defending division champs took over by December. Ed Belfour anchored perhaps the NHL's best defense as they decreased their goals against average beyond even their own expectations.
First of all, Eddie Belfour has played fabulous in nets, and Chris Chelios, I think, has probably been the best defenseman in the league, but we've got a total commitment. We've got goal scorers up front that are probably sacrificing their own stats to play great defensive hockey. We're on a pace now to have 100 goals against less than we did last year, and that's why we're so successful.
It was no secret the Hawks were the team to beat in the division and the entire NHL, but they seemed to enjoy the challenge.
The word that comes to mind is consistency and working hard every day, trying to make our club a better club. The players have done a fabulous job in growing and maturing and learning to be a favorite.
Each team that that you play, you can feel how ready they are to play, and as this goes along, you know, hopefully it'll work out that we do stay on top, and I think we'll learn a lot from it each and every night out.
I like the Blackhawks, and I'm from Chicago, and I like Eddie Belfour and Doug Wilson and Chris Chelios a lot.
Hopefully it'll win it all.
While intensity was the key word to describe the Blackhawks on the ice, charitable was the key word off it. The Hawks understand their fans are the best in the NHL and took time at the fans' skate with the Hawks to show their appreciation. Because being a Blackhawk means more than being a hockey player, it means making a commitment to the community of Chicago and the state of Illinois. Nowhere is that more evident than in the charities. The Hawks are frequent visitors to area hospitals, trying to make others feel better.
This team is very giving in that way. There's a lot of guys that take part in charities almost full-time, almost year-round, and others of us that spend time, you know, during the season and stuff when we're in Chicago. So I think that it's with our team, it's fantastic.
Being a role model is one thing. Living up to it is another. And the Chicago Blackhawks 1990-91 team again represented model